let's start with the next function, that is organizing. In the last lecture, we have discussed the first function of management, that is planning, and we have discussed the importance, meaning, definition of planning. Now, next function is organizing. Now, what is organizing? It's a process of identifying and bringing all the resources. Now, resources means men, machine, material, money, method. You have to organize, you have to bring all these resources together. That comes under organization. Men means labor, machineries, then money means capital, material and methods means raw materials and everything. You bring all these things and you start working on it. Planning is done by topmost authorities and execution. Organizing means execution of those, executing those plans. This is possible under this function. Execute karna mhanje actual madhe kaam karayla suruvat karna. Planning generally higher authority kadun keli jate ani to plan actual madhe work karna mhanje execution cha kaam kontya function madhe hota, organizing madhe. Now they have given the definition of Kuntz and O'Donnell. According to him, it is the grouping of activities. Why grouping of activities is done? To accomplish the goals and plans. Whatever the goals, whatever the plans in the planning has all in the planning we have already decided. In organizing, we start to accomplish, to achieve those goals and plans. For that purpose, you start assigning the work, assignment of work and provision for authority, delegation and coordination. All these things are covered in Kuntz and O'Donnell definition. You have to buy it. Now let's move on to the next part, that is importance of organizing. Importance of organizing. First is facilitates administration as well as operation. Administration and operation means what? Day-to-day activities. Day-to-day madhe apan je kai office activities kiwa je plan actual madhe execute karto, that comes under administration and operation. So organizing facilitates administration as well as operation of the organization. Due to proper grouping of the tasks and the employees, there is increase in production and reduction. What is grouping of tasks? Grouping of tasks means, for example, if there is an accountant, chartered accountant is also there, then one auditor is there, one company secretary is there, they all are dealing with the finance. So what the company does, they group the activities. While grouping, what they do, they put the people under one same department where they need to communicate each other. So grouping of activities helps them to carry on the work smoothly. Duplication of work is restricted and effective delegation becomes possible. Delegate karna mhanje kay, dusryala dena. Next baga, specialization. This you already studied. Specialization means doing the same activity again and again leads to specialization. We have studied in Henry Fayol's principle in the last chapter, that Henry Fayol has introduced division of work. You all know division of work means dividing the work into small parts and assigning each part to the individual, to the employee, according to his likes, dislikes, experience, capabilities. I have already given you the example. Let's recollect it. Suppose there is some program, Teachers Day program, or some annual gathering is there in your college. What they will do, the committee will start delegating the work. Delegate karna mhanje dusryala dena. Delegating the work. How they delegate the work? For example, someone is good in painting, drawing, they will give the poster part to them, or someone good in anchoring will be given to them. So specialization organization means what? They have divided the work, and once you are used to it, you will become expertization. You get expertization. You will become specialized in it, and this specialization helps the organization for its performance. Next is defines the job properly. There is some organizational structure. Every organization has its own structure. Organizational structure helps in putting, for example, in the college, we have principal, then vice principal, then teachers, then students, and then maushis, kakas. So such type of organization structure is always there. Particular person has to report this manager. This 10 people have to report particular person. This is called organization structure, and in every organization they have their organizational structure. Organization structure helps in putting right man on the right job, which can be done by selecting people from various department according to their qualification. For example, here finance department, marketing department, different departments are there, production department, different departments are there, they have their manager, manager to look after. This is helping in defining job properly, which clarifies the role of every person. Next, clarifies authority and responsibility. Organization structure defines the authority as well as their responsibility also. So there will not be any confusion. Each and every person will come to know his role in the organization and his duties to be done. Next, establishes coordination. In the organization, we have different departments. There should be proper coordination, then only organization can run smoothly. And this is possible only because of organizing function and by setting organizational structure. Next is helps for effective administration. The framework of organizing defines role of each. Organizing defines role of each and every person. It defines the right job for the right person. This makes administration easy. Administration means what? To carry on that work smooth and effectively. Next, it helps growth and diversification. For growth and diversification in any organization, growth is possible only if that organization is working smoothly without any conflicts. And this is possible when you fix the duties, authority, responsibility of each manager. There will not be any confusion. Then only growth of that organization is possible. Next, creates sense of security. What is sense of security? Once they know what they have to do, for what they are eligible, for what they are responsible, then they can work without any disturbance. Organization structure clarifies the job position. It clearly states the duties and responsibilities of everyone. Everyone can work accordingly. Clarity in jobs and paths helps in increasing mental satisfaction. And if they are getting the job in a whatever the manner properly, if there are no confusion, there is no confusion, no pressure from the higher authority, if it's working smoothly, no conflicts, then it will help them to create sense of security. Next, scope of innovation. In the organization, different methods are utilized, different techniques are utilized. New managers comes with new ideas, so it creates, there is a scope for innovation. Next, helps in optimum utilization of resources. In the organization, while doing the planning, they have an idea about what type of men, machine, material, money, method they have it. Accordingly, they plan it. And therefore, due to this, specialization of work becomes possible. This right workforce utilize other resources. They know their resources, their limitations. So they use those resources to full extent. spent without wastage. So optimum utilization of resources, all resources, men, machine, material, money, method is possible in the organization. See students, planning, after planning, next function is organizing. Planning is topmost people activities, intellectual activities. Intellectual means related to brain. जे एकदम ज्याच्यात खूप विचार करण्याची गरज असते ते प्लॅनिंग मध्ये कव्हर होतं. अँड ऍक्च्युअल एक्झिक्युशन म्हणजे प्रत्यक्षात प्लॅन आणणं, वर्किंग मध्ये आणणं, हे काम ऑर्गनायझिंग मध्ये होतं. आणि त्याच्यासाठी हे जे सगळे रिसोर्सेस आहेत हे मॅनेज केले जातात. ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन म्हणजे काय, ऍक्च्युअल काम व्यवस्थित करणं. त्याच्यानंतर ऑपरेशन म्हणजे ऍक्च्युअल काम सुरुवात होणं. स्पेशलायझेशन मध्ये काय म्हणतो आपण, तेच काम करून. हेनरी फेअर मध्ये वी हॅव ऑलरेडी कव्हर्ड की तेच काम करून त्या व्यक्तीला स्पेशलायझेशन येतं. बट ते काम देताना पण लाईफ, डिसलाईक्स, एक्सपिरियन्स ह्या सगळ्या फॅक्टर्स कन्सिडर करून दिले जातात. त्यानंतर डिफाईन्स जॉब, तुम्हाला ऑर्गनायझेशन स्ट्रक्चर असतं, कोणी कोणाला रिपोर्टिंग करायचं हे माहिती असतं. त्यामुळे जॉब तुम्हाला काय करायचं आहे, तुम्हाला ऑफिसमध्ये गेल्यावर काय करायचं आहे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, माय जॉब, माय रोल इज टू teach students economics and OCM. So I know my responsibility. So it defines the job properly. It clarifies the authority and responsibility. The person should know his authority in the organization. त्याची ऑथॉरिटी त्याला माहिती असली पाहिजे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, माझी ऑथॉरिटी काय असू शकते की मी एखादा स्टुडंट मिसबिहेव करत असेल तर त्याला त्याच्याविरुद्ध काय ॲक्शन घेणार, दॅट इज माय ऑथॉरिटी. आणि काही प्रॉब्लेम झाला, मी अचानक काहीतरी डिसाईड केलं आणि कॉलेज सोडतो, ती माझी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी असली पाहिजे. मीन्स ऑथॉरिटी शुड, यू शुड ऑल्सो नो युअर ऑथॉरिटी, यू शुड बी अवेअर अबाउट द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑल्सो. एस्टॅब्लिशेस कोऑर्डिनेशन. कोऑर्डिनेशन मीन्स डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट्स मध्ये कोऑर्डिनेशन असणं गरजेचं आहे. दे हॅव फायनान्स, मार्केटिंग, प्रोडक्शन, डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट्स आर देअर. पीपल आर वर्किंग इन डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट्स. देअर शुड बी कोऑर्डिनेशन. कोऑर्डिनेशन म्हणजे एकमेकांमध्ये तेवढं कम्युनिकेशन पाहिजे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, जर समजा 12th स्टँडर्डचे तुमच्या कॉलेजमध्ये 3 डिव्हिजन, एक एक्झाम डिक्लेअर केली, एका क्लासमध्ये वेगळा टॉपिक, दुसऱ्या क्लासमध्ये वेगळा टॉपिक, तिसरा वेगळा, टीचरनी वेगळाच हे केलं, असं नसतं. कोऑर्डिनेशन पाहिजे की आर क्लास हॅज कवर्ड दिस सिलॅबस अप टू दिस. देअर शुड बी कोऑर्डिनेशन. सो हेल्प्स फॉर इफेक्टिव्ह ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. सेम पॉईंट इज देअर. इफेक्टिव्ह ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मीन्स द वर्किंग शुड बी स्मूथली. Growth and diversification. See, in the organization, there are no conflict. If it's working properly without any disturbance, then there are chances for growth and diversification. It creates sense of security, then scope of innovation. There is a scope for new ideas, methods. Managers comes with new methods, new techniques. So it has scope for innovation because it in the organization, actual work is less. And one more is there, optimum utilization of resources. So whatever the resources you have, you start using it properly without, to full extent, without wastage. We have done with the second function, that is organizing. Planning is the basic function. Once the plan is done, organization start organizing men, machine, material, money, method. Next function is staffing. We will discuss